Welcome to my vlogs. Sometimes life is an uphill struggle. Beyond the sea, somewhere waiting for me. Just ask my family, or even my animals. And watches the ships that go sailing somewhere. Or even my more unusual animals. It's about quality control and extensive help and trust. Welcome to my world. Hi, in this vlog I will be showing you around my tropical fish tanks. I hope you enjoy seeing them all.
It's the smallest of my tanks. It's got 64 litres of water in. It's home mainly to a very young bunch of mollies, blue mollies, and there are also four baby bristlenose plecos that I bought, and they're sort of being brought up by two adult bristlenose. I'm just going to come down to one of the bristlenose now. They're very cute. Put a nice piece of courgette in there so we can have a munch on that. They like to eat not just vegetables but also some meat, so we put some meaty pellets in. But these guys do like to have their algae and whatever. They're very funny and they change colour, and as youngsters they're trying to work out what the best colour is to change into hide. So I don't know if you can see, but under there's another baby and there is an adult, but so good at hiding. I'll have to show you a photograph of him. You can tell the adults when they're bristlenose because their noses are bristles. Is there male? But not if they're female. So an adult has bristly nose if it's a male, and no bristles or very little bristles if it's a female. And these baby bristle noses are very fun. Jumping about. Some of the blue mollies having to play.
We can see here the adult male. You see the bristles on his nose. His name is Lemon Tea, and his partner is called Coffee, and she's actually dark, so she's sort of a black coffee. Here's one of the babies. You can just about see the bristles on the end of its nose, so it's going to be a little boy. At this age, the girls don't have any bristles. They do remind me of Muppets. We have four of them in this tank. They sort of hop around. They can swim. They just sort of hop around and jump. And they're eating the algae off their glass. As you zoom in, you can see the scaly skin, and they have the ability to change their appearance.
This is my Rio 125. That means it's a 125 litre tank. In here I have some shiny little fishies known as neon tetras. I've got some selfie mollies, you can see them darting around, and some blue mollies. I've just moved some of the plants, so they're quite active at the moment. I think we may have babies in here soon. But also on another video you'll see my elephant nose fish. Very unusual fishy, a little bit difficult to look after, but he's great fun. And you'll see that on another video in a minute.
Yeah, I noticed about Walter is that he has what looks like to be a nose, but actually it's his chin. His mouth is just above it. He'll use it to go sieving through the sand to find food, or bumping into the other fish. As you look around the tank now, we can see the loaches darting around. There's three loaches. One of them is a bit bigger than the others, so we call him Fat Loach. They are quite funny. They're called yo-yo loaches because the patterns on the side says the word yo-yo. Yes, Fat Loach. The little balloon belly molly there that's tucked into the wafer pellet, the yellowy one. His name is Chaos, or her name is Chaos. So we've got two little babies in the tank at the moment, a little whitish one and a yellowy one. So we don't know whether they're selfie mollies or balloon belly mollies yet, they're too young to find out. And feeding time. So we're going a bit frenzy, so we're feeding them here some frozen bloodworm. So we defrost it. Walter the elephant fish loves this. He sucks it up like spaghetti. You can see him jumping out to see where I put it in by the water outlet. The other fish will eat the bloodworm, but they mainly eat a flake. So in here as well we've got some penguins. They're not penguins and the birds, these are fish that shoal together and they sort of point upwards, and with a line going down they look like penguin. So this is my Rio 125 tank. And just a final look at Walter. Definitely my most unusual fish.
Okay, so this is my biggest tank. This is my 240 litre tank. And I'm going to zoom in a moment and introduce you to a few of my fishies. We do tend to name them all. My daughter's looking at me as if I'm mad. Okay, so let's see. Let's have a little go in here. See a bit of action over to the right hand side here. Okay, so we've got the big yellow one. There's Mr. and Mrs. Guami. That's Mrs. Guami, you can see there. Mr. Guami's over the other side. He'll be back in a minute. The two silvery blue ones, they're Guamis as well. Opine Guamis, can't say it. One's called Mary, the other one's called Chris, as in Merry Christmas, because guess what time of year we got them? No, it wasn't Easter. There's a black one flying around there. Whee! Okay. That is Wembley, and he's got two girlfriends. One's called Arena, and one's called Stadium. And we think they may be pregnant. So, right, there we go. That one there is Arena. Yeah, that one with the black tail.
Which
That's
one?
Arena. That's Arena.
Which one? That one's Arena.
Okay, just so you can see what's happening, this is my daughter trying to stay out of camera shot and running through. Okay, now you can understand why I've entitled this video My Family and Other Animals, because I don't know what is more sensible, my animals or my family. Certainly my daughters are not as sensible as my fish. Okay, so I'm very proud of this tank. While I've been off ill from work, I've been trying to apply my mind to something, and it's been this tank, really. So what we've got is a huge piece of bogwood, and because some of the smaller fish I'll introduce you to in a minute need a piece of bogwood to live on, forms part of their diet. But it's supposed to simulate a river, and on one end we've got a bit of a... I'm going to put my thing up there to see if I can point to it. This way over here, this is like it's all slate, so it's sort of like my little quarry end. And then I've got my big piece of bogwood sweeping around here. So it's sort of a river, and coming this way is the water current. So you can see the way the way the grasses are twisting over because of the power of the current of the water. So there's a constant flow of water going across, and actually the water comes across the top and it whizzes down and it comes back again. So it's sort of goes in this motion here. So there we go. I'm not too sure why my daughters are doing this. This is because they don't want to be in the video. Completely daft.
Some of our fish only come out at night, so I have some blue lighting that I can put on to encourage them to come out so they think it's the moon. So this is looking down the tank from the end. This is Barney. The angelfish can be quite spiteful to each other. Always fighting. They paired up and they've got their territory either end of the tank, but they do fight. It's like a children's playground. My albino chocolate pleco. These are my plecos and my catfish. Well, plecos, strictly speaking, are catfish as well. Stubby, little clown pleco. My flash pleco there. And that's Sheridan. Sheridan is a upside down catfish. In the bottom you can see the tigery one. That's tiger. He's a tiger pleco. And that white thing going in front, that's an albino cori. Also a member of the catfish family. Oh look, here comes an angelfish. Always trying to come into the act. And because I like him so much, is my flash. And my new one, my golden nugget. And the ones you haven't seen yet, my little Swartz cori.
She can tell. You pull it out. Can you get hold of that?
You can't be bad.
Get hold of that. Can you bite it? He
wants to
you do, G? Hey, can you do it?
No. Sugar.